Hello, I'm Nicole. Welcome back to my channel. After today's session, you will learn most of the frequency words and how to express illness and symptoms. If you don't want to miss out, remember to subscribe my channel and turn on the little bell.
Text 1.
你很少生病，是不是喜欢运动？
是啊，我每天早上都要出去跑步。
你每天几点起床？
我每天6点起床。
你很少生病，是不是喜欢运动？是啊，我每天早上都要出去跑步。你每天几点起床？我每天6点起床。你很少生病，是不是喜欢运动？是啊，我每天早上都要出去跑步。你每天几点起床？我每天6点起床。你很少生病，是不是喜欢运动？是啊，我每天早上都要出去跑步。你每天几点起床？我每天6点起床。
You rarely get sick. It's not like sports. Yes, me every day, morning.All need out go run. You every day, what time up bed? Me every day, 6 o'clock up bed.
Okay, this is my way to translate, and the exactly English way of the translation you can see on the page. For translating this way will help you to understand the Chinese structure.Okay, let's see the grammar. The first one, 很少。很少 means seldom, rarely. Can similar to 不经常。很少不经常 nearly same. And the opposite words of them, that would be 经常。经常 can be translated to frequently or do something a lot. At this point, has a common mistake many students made it.For example, like this English, I travel a lot. Many students will translate to 我旅行很多 because a lot means 很多. But actually, in Chinese, we need to say 我经常旅行 because if I do something a lot, which means I do it frequently. More examples.
你经常打篮球吗？经常，我每周末都去。
Normally, after answering whether or not, as part of a normal daily conversation, we will also inform the person asking about the specific frequency at doing this thing.
你经常旅行吗？
很少，我总是没有时间。Some other frequency words,
总是、通常、常常、经常、有时候、偶尔、不经常、很少、罕见的、难得、从不、绝不。
Examples, 他总是迟到。我通常早上8点起床。
我经常去健身。我有时候会去图书馆看书。我偶尔吃一次西餐。
我不经常喝酒。他今天难得早起。他从不抽烟。 生病, get sick. This is a verb phrase. The meaning of 病 is sick, noun, sickness. In Chinese, there are several structures to express being sick. Let's have a look at the first one. The subject can be a people or animal. A name of the illness, le. The le indicating it has occurred. This structure is more commonly used to say common illness, something everyone may get and not very severe. 我晕车了，我拉肚子了，我花粉过敏了，我发烧了。And of course, we don't always want to directly tell others the specific illness we are having. In such cases, you can simply say, 我生病了。The second structure, also subject, with 得了and the name of the sick. When someone contracts a relatively uncommon or more serious illness, we use this structure. 我得了中耳炎 and other serious illness.肺癌、白血病、糖尿病。This follows a similar structure, and in many cases, the terms can be interchangeable. People, 有, a name of the sick.
他有糖尿病，所以需要经常测血糖。他去年得了糖尿病。
The first one, 他得了糖尿病. And this one is emphasize the time of diagnosis or the fact of having the disease. Typically, the context will include time-related words.
他有糖尿病
is more general, indicating that he has this illness, but may not emphasize the time of diagnosis or specific details.And this expression is more common in everyday spoken language, and it used to discuss a people's long-term health issue that has been present for a while. Next structure. Subject, 犯, a name of the sick. This one normally be used for some chronic illnesses. We may always have such problems such as headaches or like a stomachache or toothache and so on. Most of the time, we may be fine, but occasionally, when the symptoms flare up, we need to use 犯.
我头疼犯了。我最近鼻炎犯了。
In daily life, sometimes we may feel a little bit uncomfortable, which may not necessarily be an illness. We can say 不舒服 to express discomfort, or we can directly use our body part with 疼. 疼 is painful.
我今天不舒服。我肚子不舒服。牙疼。肚子疼。头疼。
Okay, recently in the UK, there is a crazy flu going around. So how describe it?
我得流感了，头很晕，嗓子也很疼，还发烧了。昨天烧到了38度，今天退烧了，但是还是不舒服。
The symptoms of stomachache.
我昨天可能吃了不干净的东西。今天肚子很不舒服，一直拉肚子。
On our next video for Dialogue 2, we will learn how to tell others about the improvement and recovery of our sickness condition. I will also explain some expressions related to COVID-19.
每都
每 every
每天 every day
都
all.
Normally, 每 something will be used together with 都 do something.
我们每个圣诞节都要吃烤火鸡。他每个周末都要回他爸爸妈妈家。
The use of such 每 and 都 combinations makes the sentences more persuasive, emphasizing the importance of a concept like.Each, everyone, every day, every time. But we don't have to use the 都 Now what's the difference between 我每天五点起床 and 我每天都五点起床? You can notice when I read these two sentences, my stress is different. So 我每天都五点起床. This one you can say my stress is on 每天都. I'm emphasize, I do this every day. 几点? In English, words like time and place are usually placed at the end of a sentence, but in Chinese, it's a little bit different. They are typically placed within the sentence. 我们今天9点看了电影。 我6点要上中文课。 Okay, this is all of today's part. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. If you don't want to miss out all of the content I provide, don't forget subscribing my channel and turning on the little bell. We'll see you in next video. Bye-bye.